Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, April 30th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. We are going to have a much cooler day today in many parts of the Garden State, but temperatures are going to vary widely. Our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says we could see 60s all the way up to some 80s, and then some changes on the way tonight as thunderstorms could be rolling in. Full forecast details available on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. Dozens of protesters have taken over a building on the campus of Columbia University in New York City. They've unfurled a Palestinian flag as protests against the Israel-Hamas war continue to increase on college campuses throughout our nation. This is the latest escalation of the demonstrations. 13 protesters were arrested trying to take over an administrative building on the campus of Princeton University. Protesters have also set up an encampment at the New Brunswick campus of Rutgers University. Nationwide, the number of arrests connected to these demonstrations is nearing 1,000. Generally, students are demanding their schools cut ties with Israel as the death toll among Palestinians in Gaza continues to rise. A man and a woman in Warren County have been arrested for leaving two toddlers in a car while they attended a wine tasting. According to the Warren County prosecutor, 43-year-old John O'Mahony and 37-year-old Radhika Vyas went to the Four Sisters Winery in White Township in late February. Staff at the winery called police after they noticed the man and woman had left two toddlers in their vehicle for 20 minutes while they enjoyed the wine tastings. Kids were later found unharmed, but O'Mahony and Vyas were both charged last week with child neglect. The latest Drag Queen Story Hour to be canceled in New Jersey comes on the campus of Brookdale Community College. School officials cited respect for the comfort levels of its employees in announcing there would be no Drag Queen read-along among the events they had scheduled for Bring Your Child to Work Day, and also followed intense pressure from community members and Republican lawmakers. Donald Trump's presidential campaign has already forwarded some big bucks to a New Jersey town that'll be hosting a huge rally for him in May. According to a document obtained by New Jersey 101.5, the campaign paid a $200 application fee and then wired the city of Wildwood $40,000. The Trump campaign has been known to run up bills for public safety and not pay them. According to the Center for Public Integrity, which reported in 2019, his campaign had over $800,000 in unpaid bills from 10 cities. He scheduled a rally for May 11th. Up to 40,000 people are expected to attend. Governor Murphy does want to spend a record amount of our money on school aid for districts across the state of New Jersey. But that's not good news for all of them. Some districts are going to be looking at a dramatic loss of school aid. Some state lawmakers are trying to remedy that this morning. Republican Assemblyman Brian Rump sponsors a measure that says the amount of state aid headed to a school district cannot drop by more than 1% in a single year. The measure is in response to some districts preparing to receive millions less in state aid this year. This is the final year of a phased-in law signed by Governor Murphy in 2018 that aims to give every district the money it needs to provide a thorough and efficient education. A 49-year-old man is now accused of setting multiple fires at the same address in Monmouth County. Albert Caparoso was arrested last week after Hazlet police saw him trying to set a storage shed on fire. Fires were set at the same neighboring property six times starting back in December. The 49-year-old Caparoso, who lives in town, has been charged with seven counts of aggravated arson, but there is no indication what prompted him to allegedly start those fires. Big changes in federal rules could make it easier for you to figure out how much it costs to fly. It might even make it cheaper. Automatic refunds, doing away with hidden fees, for example. Jersey Congressman Josh Gottheimer trying to get these rules on the books for good so they can't be scrapped by a new administration. Among the rules, airlines will be required to provide refunds for canceled or significantly delayed flights. The rules also address booking fees, requiring you to know up front what it'll cost to check a bag or to change your flight. Have something to say about our top stories? You can leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, April 30th. It's made possible by the Vet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.